Perfect. Yeah, thank you. Nice to meet you. It's
Likewise.
that we have a chance to talk about the power of Cato. I'm Matthias, head of innovation at Enseia, and I'm always excited about talk about smart solutions to support digital readiness and mobile productivity. Could you please introduce yourself as well, short, and leave a few words, who you are, what do you do?
Okay, so my name is Eyal. I'm Vice President of Product Marketing here at Cato Network. I'm with the company for 5 years. Initially, I was the head of product management from within the engineering. And about 2.5 years ago, I transitioned to lead the product marketing work here at Cato.
Mm-hmm. Correct, exciting. Let's directly head over to the first question. Crazy times in all the online and remote activity. How could Cato Cloud help customers to address the current challenges of the COVID pandemic, or especially to optimize and simplify the work from home office?
So Cato's global backbone and integrated security is what allows enterprises to move their employees to work from remote without any compromising. They don't need to compromise on the network performance, which otherwise negatively affects the productivity of the enterprise. And they don't need to compromise on security because security is already part of the remote connectivity. In the alternative solution, what IT teams need to do with COVID is to scale up their physical remote access or VPN solutions, figure out how to overcome the challenges of productivity or performance, very often at the expense of giving away some of their security and forces and controls in order to maintain as productive as possible our remote access.
Okay, exciting insights. Okay, yeah, cool, thank you. And in the latest product update, you mentioned there were announced the device authentication feature that you let enforce a policy that only allow authorized corporate devices to connect to the network. I think it's a really exciting feature to combine the solutions for SASE for cloud first strategy and mobile device management or device management totally. So how do Cato integrate in other third-party system, and which providers would you highlight, like Azure, Okta, whatever?
Of course. So first of all, for single sign-on, we integrate with all the leading IDPs like Okta, Azure, of course, Ping, you know, also Google for authentication. So whoever the enterprise is already using as their IDP and single sign-on platform, we can integrate with that. Everything is already has automatic discovery protocol. So it really takes few minutes at most to have that integration done. And then we can identify the user. But the device authentication is actually a step beyond the user authentication. It's also the understanding of what device the user is using to connect and the abilities to set policies based on that. Let me give you an example. I have a user in the enterprise that has authenticated with Office 365 or with Azure AD into the Cato SDP solution. Now, if he's coming from a corporate device, I can set a rule that says he is allowed to access specific cloud applications and on-premise file servers. But if he's connecting from a bring your own device, which is a non-managed device that I can't guarantee the security of, then I would limit their access or his or her access only to Office 365, and that's it. So this gives me much more granular ability to still allow access to critical applications, but differentiate between corporate device access and bring your own device access.
Okay, I think it's essential in the zero terms of zero trust to set up the entire concept. Okay, great. Yeah, the same as we noticed so far. And another one that we noticed is that some IT managers aren't fully aware of what all the services are being used in their organization, and they lack of the desired visibility. How could Cato help to gain transparency or identify shadow IT, for example?
So shadow IT is a very big problem, especially now that there's internet everywhere, and it is so simple to just sign up with whatever you know, SaaS that is out there or cloud application, even for the most basic things like sending a big file to a partner or to a prospect or a customer, it completely got out of IT's control. And what Cadre does, because we are the network and the security, is that once you move the network to the Cadre platform, you instantly get full visibility to all the cloud applications in use. And from there, it is much more simpler and feasible to actually enforce policies of sanctioned and unsanctioned cloud applications. If you compare this to a world of appliances that are globally distributed, then you need to correlate, to collect logs from all the appliances, figure out what's going on, and then build a policy and push it down to the different appliances in order to achieve something that is similar to what I described.
Yeah, I think the cloud first strategy all pushes those issues or the lacks of the visibility. Okay, cool. Yeah, I think you already convinced me. going to start to set up our Cadre infrastructure. What would be the best starting point if a customer or IT manager want to set up the Cadre?
So the beautiful thing about Cadre SASE is that we're completely open to where our customers would like to start. And we actually encourage them to start where it hurts them most. If they feel that the security is not under their control and the enterprise is not secured enough, start with migrating to our security. If your pain is around the limitation, rigidity, and high cost of MPLS, let's start with the network. If the challenge is around access from China to the rest of the world, we can solve that point and later on expand as you use our services. Or if right now the biggest pain is remote access, let's focus on that. Just get on the SASE platform, start your SASE migration journey, and then take it step by step, securely and with confidence after you know our platform and achieve whatever it is you want to achieve for your IT and enterprise. You don't have to migrate everything overnight. That's completely not the best practice of SASE migration.
Yeah, as always, simply start with the first footstep. Great, great, Eyal. Thanks, exciting insights. It's far from the interview. I appreciate your feedback in this session. I wish you a nice day and hopefully we'll meet in person the next time.
Hopefully, yes. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.